Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1931. QuickBooks concatenate, but avoid name address. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, last week I did that Power Excel seminar down in Miami, and lots of great questions came out of the seminar. So all this week I'll be showing questions that came from that seminar, and I instantly recognized this question when it came up because it happens to me as well. Someone was using QuickBooks for their accounting software, and when you download the customer list from QuickBooks, we have two fields. We have a name field and an address field, and for whatever reason, over the years, many of the items in the address field have the name as the starting value, but then others do not, right? I don't know if QuickBooks changed how they handled this over the years, or I'm just inconsistent about the way that I enter data, or it's whether it was imported or not imported. But, you know, I recognize this. So when we concatenate column A and column B over here, sometimes we're getting the name twice, like Boeing, Boeing, Ford, Ford, and so on. And so how do you know whether or not to concatenate A and B or just use only B? And so my solution here was to say equal if the left of column B, and how many characters do I want to check? I want to check the length of column A. So look at the leftmost characters of column B and see if that's equal to the name over in A2. And if it is, then I simply want column B. Otherwise, I want column A, ampersand, quote, space, quote, ampersand, column B, close the if statement. And with that simple little bit of logic there, copy it down. It's smart enough to pull over the customer name and then the address if the address doesn't start with the customer name. Otherwise, it pulls over just the address which has the customer name already. All right, so two different functions there, left and len inside of an if function. So I guess a total of three functions. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast, Mr. Excel.